For 2 straight weeks, a loosely organized group called Occupy Wall Street has been trying to capture the discontent of America and ignite a movement. And as Michelle Miller reports, there are signs that the campaign may be spreading beyond New York City.
They've turned parts of New York's financial district into a campground. Hundreds of activists, sometimes more, venting frustration over the direction of this country.
My father's been unemployed for a couple of years. We got foreclosed on, and my sister's in college with tuition that we can't afford.
Musician Hero Vincent has been here since day one.
We're all here for one reason, and that's accountability.
It's a diverse group, from college graduates to perennial protesters. They've captured attention. And Saturday on the Brooklyn Bridge, they even stopped traffic. That led to 700 arrests.
I think what you're seeing now is actually an organic grassroots movement that doesn't have an organized leadership behind it.
Faz Shakir says, unlike the Tea Party, these protests lack a unified message.
I think it makes it much more harder for people to understand what is galvanizing all these people. What are the various messages of these people?
They are focused in other respects, feeding their troops through donations, even publishing their own newspaper. And they're gaining support from established organizations, including the AFL-CIO, but have yet to draw bigger political allies.
Demonstrations like this are planned in at least 10 cities across the nation, an indication that their message, no matter how varied, spreading. Michelle Miller, CBS News, New York.